very warm good morning to one and all. Myself Pradeep Kumar N, and I completed my BSc from the College of Horticulture, Mysore, UHS Bagalkot, and I completed my MSc from the Division of Vegetable Science, IRI, and presently I am pursuing first year PhD in Division of Vegetable Science, IRI. Okay, with this introduction, I will go to my presentation. And my allotted topic is the cucurbits crops. Definitely, you will get around 16 to 20 mass questions from these crops. Okay, so I will go with the step by step, and then plenty of information it is there. If you read my presentation today, you would definitely you will answer all the questions. I will surely I'm telling you. Okay, so you don't. Go with here and there, and then hear the what I am telling, and then note as a time. Okay, and take the snapshot and then make your own notes and prepare them. Okay, okay. Why I am putting this slide? It is because our preparation should be continuous, not in a gap wise. Okay, if suppose any water it is coming, it is in a gap. Definitely that source will not reach to the plant, so definitely that plants will not grow nicely. Okay, so if our preparation should be frequent or in the continuous, definitely our knowledge will be built. Okay, then coming to the question pattern. Okay, it is visible, sir.
Yes, visible, sir.
And my voice also audible?
Yeah, audible, clearly audible.
Okay, this is the question paper pattern. If anybody is not known, please take here. Okay, there are 120 questions for the JRF as well as the SRF. It is there, and my this class will be both SRF as well as the JRF. Okay, and then 2 hours exam is there, and then multiple choice. Here also three sections it is there in the SRF, that is A section, B section and C section. Okay, and here also match the following is there, and statement type question. This is the nowadays it is a fashion for the ICR pattern of examination, and the any this in the ICR pattern, and 20 questions agriculture it is there in the SRF as well as the JRF, and then we will see next. Okay, this is the syllabus for both horticulture. It is for the JRF. Okay, if anybody don't have, please take syllabus wise you have to read. Then coming to the actual topic. Okay, today we will discuss the introduction to the cucurbits. Who will see this topic today? Definitely it will give you a plenty of information, and then you will this class will definitely helpful for the frequent whatever the next class means crop wise I am dealing na, so there it will also helpful. So you take means seriously this class. Okay, then coming to the classification. Here in the classification, the chromosome classification I will go with here. Definitely one or two questions it will come from this slide. Cucumber, that is the 14, and then here I am given the 22 chromosome having the cucurbits, that is the bitter gourd, bottle gourd, snake gourd, pointed gourd and watermelon. Here is the code B²SPW. If you remember, this is the 22 chromosome number. Okay, then coming to the 24 chromosome number. Here if you remember AMGLS, it is for the 24 chromosome number. The crops like ash gourd, ivy gourd, muskmelon, and then gherkins, long melon and snap melon. Okay, then coming to the luffa, the 26 chromosome number it is there na, so wherever you will found luffa it will come for the 22 chromosome 26 chromosome number. If you blindly if you remember, okay, luffa it will come. Okay, that is 26 chromosome number, that is a rich gourd and sponge gourd, only two. Then coming to the 28, here the sweet gourd, spine gourd and chocho, so 28. This is a crystal clear here. Okay, then coming to the cucurbita, if you found anywhere in the scientific name cucurbita, you choose the option of the chromosome number 40. Okay, then coming to the one special cucurbit, that is the teasel gourd. teasel god, that is the Memotica subungulata subspecies Ranigera. This is the cross between, definitely the question frame, the person will ask this question. Okay, here they can ask three types of question. They can ask the scientific name and the spine god into sweet god cross and tetraploid. Very, very important this one. It is a tetraploid, and 56 is the chromosome number. Then coming to the, what is the haploid chromosome number and what is the basic chromosome number? No, many of the students, they are very confused about the, what is the haploid chromosome. Haploid chromosome number, here I am given some hint. 2n is equal to 2x is equal to 40. It is for the cucumber chromosome number. Na? So n, it is the chromosome number 7, it will come. Okay, that 7 chromosomes are present in the gametes. Either it may be pollen grains or it may be in the egg cell. Okay, that chromosome number sets is called haploid chromosome number. Okay, then coming to the basic chromosome number. Basic chromosome number, it is only seen or the for the examination purpose wherever the polyploids is there, like okra is a polyploid, leeket is a polyploid, rhubarb it is also a polyploid. Okay, so and the potato it is also a polyploid. So there they will ask the basic chromosome number. Definitely in these crops. So here see what is the I am taking an example leek. The 2n is equal to 4x is equal to 32. Then what is the x? X is the basic chromosome number. Here n, it is the 16. N, we know n is equal to 32. 2 is equal to 32 divided by 2. You will come the 16. That is the n. That is haploid chromosome number. Then coming to the basic chromosome number. That is, you will take the 4x and 32, and x is equal to 32 divided by 4, we will get the 8. What is the 8 then? We know, okay, 16, that is present in the gametes. Where this 8 indicates? The x is the basic chromosome number, means the 4 sets, see, 4 it is there now, and x this one. 4 sets of each set, 8 chromosome numbers is there. So that is the basic chromosome number knowledge. So coming to the origin of cucurbits, here you will see all the cucurbits origin here. If you remember this slide, you definitely answer the all the questions related to the origin of cucurbits. Coming to the, what are the cucurbits origin in the India? You see, cucumber, it is origin in India, bitter gourd, pointed gourd, snake gourd, ivy gourd and luffa. Definitely examiner will focus on these questions. Okay, then coming to the other cucurbits, where it is origin? The Mexico, it is exactly come here. The pumpkin, squash and chocho, here origin of these crops in Mexico. And tropical Africa, definitely these are the very sweetest cucurbits, their origin in the Africa. So they like the what are the crops like melons and watermelons. Okay, and if you see, all the cucurbits are origin in the tropical as well as the subtropical parts of the world. So see, all they are origin in the these part only, not in the temperate regions, only in the tropical and subtropical parts of the world. Then definitely put a 10 star mark here. One or two questions it will come in the SRF as well as JRF. Okay, nowadays the pattern is exam pattern is both SRF as well as JRF, it is coming in the same way. So the JRF students, it is also you should also read like a SRF student. Okay, so here the 10 star marks you put, and then please take a snapshot of this one. I have given here all the progenitors, like cucumber it is Hardwicki, here is the photo, and then watermelon colosynthesis it is there like this one, and then muskmelon it is a metalliferous. So you see, this is the metalliferous muskmelon and bottle gourd, that is the Lagenaria, Spirithica it is also there, and then Cineraria. But you consider this is the Cineraria, it is a given in the all, and moreover I am taken the all information from all the textbooks. I am not taken any slides or objective book and this one Glasters and Instant. I am taken with the source books. Okay, so I am and if you can challenge also for the ICR Sir, I am put this question, but you are given that option. Definitely, you can challenge with this answers, because I am taken the TK Bose, Tamburaj, and then this one, another one, it's the genetics and breeding of vegetable crops by T. Pradeep Kumar. Okay, and then summer squash, it is the Fratina. Winter squash, it is the Abriviana. Next pumpkin, it is the Lundeliana. Snake god, that is the Trichosanthus lobata. This is the bitter god, bottle god, and then this is a spine god. And definitely here also you put a 10 star mark. Definitely they will ask one question related to genome size, or the which species they have genome sequence, or which year they done. My SRF time they asked this question. Okay, 2009. So here I am taking the only cucurbits, so I am focused on the cucurbits like a cucumber, it is a 367, and watermelon, it is a 425 megabase pair, that is 2012, it is the genome sequence, whole genome sequence it is done. Okay, all the chromosomes studied in these crops, whole genome sequence it is done. And muskmelon is a 450 megabase pair, 2012. Okay, and if you take all the crops of vegetable crops here in one slide, okay, I have all the chromosomes information of cucumber, because I worked on the cucumber in my MSc program, and I sequenced ethylene synthesis genes in the cucumber, and within a short time I will publish my article in the genomics article. Coming to the different sex form in the cucurbits, here also definitely four marks questions they can ask here. Which are the dioecious cucurbits? Where I am stressing, definitely there it will come question in your exam. So be careful. Dioecious, what are the dioecious cucurbits then? Pointed god, ivy god, spine god, sweet god, and teasel god. Okay, and another one in the Luffa species, Luffa ichinata. Okay, that is also a dioecious nature. And then another in the watermelon, that is the Citrullus naudinianus. I am not added through two species like Luffa ichinata and Citrullus naudinianus. These are also dioecious nature. Okay, try to remember from this line. And then gynaecious lines also they can ask. And then trimonoecious, cucumber as well as Luffa, these three questions examination they can focus definitely. Then coming to the origin of sex forms in the cucurbits, okay, how the sex forms is origin in the cucurbits. See, in the cucurbits, the first flower origin in the plants, all are hermaphrodites. Okay, hermaphrodites. Then the flower will come initially in the cucurbits at the young stage. After that, there may be a deletion of male part or female part. Then it will going to produce as the female flower or male flower. Or it may not deletion of any sex, it will go into the hermaphrodite flowers also. Okay, I hope you are understand, like hermaphrodite, either a male part it will delete it, it will going to produce the female flower. If it is a female part, it is deleted or mutated, it will going to produce as the male flowers. So that question, how it will come, what is the primitive sex form of cucurbits? Hermaphrodite. And then what is the monoecious cucurbit they can ask? This is the predominant sex form, dominant sex form, and advanced sex form. Okay, and gynaecious cucurbit, that is the economic sex form. Okay, here they can ask the three questions from this slide. Okay, coming to the next slide, here I am given the complete genetic information of the sex strides in the cucurbits. Okay, in coming slides also it is there, but here also you can focus. The pitter god, gynaecious line, it is the GY gene. Definitely they can ask this question. And then watermelon, that is also same, and ridge god, that is the G. And then in cucumber, if you see some papers, they give a small GY, or in some papers they can give capital GY1. Definitely go with the option capital GY1. Why? I will tell you, because that is present in the genetics and breeding of vegetable crops, that is the ICR publication. They are given capital GY1. So you go with the capital GY1 question. And see, trimonicious sex form is the highly unstable sex form. Coming to the next slide, then the questioner will ask the one question from this slide. The whatever, if you plant the cucurbit seeds, that will produce the only male flowers at initial stage. Then after that, if you go after some cycle of growth, it will bear the both male and female flowers. After that, it will at the reproductive stage, it will bear only female flowers. Okay, this sequence they can ask. Okay, then what is the all the cucurbits are day neutral, and cucurbit acinate is more highest in the root crops, leaves and fruits. The questions may ask like this: we can put in the leaves first and fruit first, or roots first. So you go with the option roots, leaves as well as fruits. Okay, then flower development, this question it is asked in the ERS, yeah, and then NET exam, and in Karnataka some horticulture related questions they ask this question. So you be careful about this one. Okay, what is the flower development steps in the cucurbits? First, ovary develops. Okay, and it is the inferior ovary, and calyx develops next, and petals, then followed by stamens. Okay, this sequence you remember. All the cucurbits are C3 cucurbits except ivy gourd C4, and then apart from other vegetables, say amaranthus is there, and then poi, that is a Malabar spinach, and date palm, some are also there. Date palm, other cucurbits, other vegetable crops or fruit crops you remember. Sechium, that is a chow chow, it is also called choete. It is a single seeded cucurbit. Okay, then it one question they can ask, which cucurbits having the spiny nature of pollen grain, that is the chow chow. Definitely they can ask this question. And coccinia, this question they may ask. And luffa, this is also, you know, luffa, there is a one product, it will come like that is the Arabic word, that is a sponge like structure, it can use as a scrubber. Okay, then important points about the cucurbits, like what is the which is the cucurbit having the water content highest, that is go with the option ash gourd, that is 96.5%, followed by cucumber and then watermelon. It is the TKBOS information. Okay, you go with this option. And then bitter gourd, so sorry, here I given first is a bitter gourd. Go with the option which is the cucurbit having the highest iron content, that is the watermelon, not the bitter gourd. Okay, you see that watermelon having the 7.9 milligrams per 100 gram, but in the bitter gourd 2 milligrams per 100 gram. Okay, if any have the doubt, you come with the doubt, I will give the exact source also with the picture. You will definitely, you can challenge the ICR also. Okay, then chow chow, it is a highly nutritive cucurbit, that is a calcium, that is the 140 milligrams per 100 gram. And then Memodica dioica, it is the vitamin C as well as the rich in the protein, Kurtoli, this is the Kurtoli. And sweet gourd, it is a cacrol. Pumpkin, it is a beta carotene rich, Arka Chandar, you can see the figure also here. And then Coccinia grandis, this is the first coccinia. Okay, this is the sex determination in cucurbits like a human beings. Why? Because human beings, like, it is a sex determination. Here the XY chromosomes are present for the sexual differentiation of these cucurbits. Okay, then hermaphrodite form of the bears in the Satputia as well as the Kashi Kaushi, these two cucurbits varieties you remember, this bears the hermaphrodite flowers. You can see the figure also in the next coming slides. Okay, and in the cucurbits, inferior ovary it is there, and then generally the fruit is called pepo. Okay, try to note it, where because I'm stressing means definitely that question will come. And then there are two types of fruit skin, it's present in the cucurbits, like a pepo, it is the hard skin, and then epithet, it is come epithet, it is the soft skin, like in bitter gourd, you know, the bitter gourd, it's a very smooth skin, so that is called epithet. And then bush squash, which is a bush squash or ornamental squash or tendril squash, tendrilless squash, that is called summer squash. Why? You can see in the next slides. So here I given definitely, here also one question may comes, you put a 10 star here, that is the common cucurbits names. What is the food of 22nd century? To go with the option watermelon. And you can also ask the ash gourd, that is the Kusmandu Aisham, and then pumpkin, that is a Kashi phal of India, and lal kaddu, and then white melon god, like wax god, it's a white god, they can also ask. Okay, and winter is called Vilayati kaddu, and then summer squash, it is a Chappan kaddu. So you take a snapshot. I cannot read all these questions, all these points, so you can read yourself and then make a short points. See, the cucurbit, the some festivals related to the vegetable crops. So I given the list of here. So pumpkin, so it is celebrated in the USA, and the watermelon, it is Australia. Okay, so you remember all the vegetable crops here. And coming to the dioecious cucurbits, here definitely one question they may ask like this: what is the dioecious crops, that is the male and female flowers, be are some separate plants. So you try to remember the definition and what are all the cucurbits may comes in the under this dioecious crops, like a pointed god, it will come, and the spine god, sweet god, ivy god, teasel god, and Lupha achinata, it will come. Then if suppose a vegetable crop, it is like a dioecious nature, how much pollinizers we have to maintain there, that is 10 to 15% of the pollinators we have to maintain for the good fruit set in the dioecious vegetable crops like cucurbits. Then coming to the which are the cucurbits having the white flowers, here see the snake god, they asked in the 2018 with the ASRB question as well as the in the NET exam, they asked the related to white flowers. So white flowers bearing cucurbits like a bottle god, it is there, pointed god, ivy god, and snake god. But in the snake god, it is somewhat different compared to all the white flower bearing cucurbits. Like a snake god, it is a fringed flowers, it is there. You can see nowhere you will found like a flowers. Okay, that is a tendril or flower, that's why, because it is a tendril like structure, and then fringed flowers, it is also we can see here. And the anthesis related, all the cucurbits, all the vegetable crops, they are morning anthesis, but some vegetable crops like a cucurbits, they are evening anthesis. What are all the cucurbits like a bottle god, snake god, ridge god? Okay, but okay, you can see in the next slide. See here, I am given the all the anthesis time of the cucurbits. This bottle god, it is there, snake god, it is there, and then ridge god. All the cucurbits, they are morning anthesis. Okay, you can take a snapshot, note it down. So here I given the typical shapes of the cucurbits. All the cucurbits like somewhat it is a different, but in there also some exceptions, like a petty pan, it is a disc shape, that is a USA introduction IHR in the summer squash, that is a disc shaped flowers. Definitely they can ask this question, not flowers, this is the fruits. And Pusa Santushti or Kaushik Kundal, that is Kashi Kundal, that is a pear shaped bottle guard. And then Pusa Sandesh and Pusa Manjari, that is a round shaped bottle guard. Pusa Arka Harik, this is a bitter guard. This question, spindle shaped flowers, they asked in the NET exam 2018. And then Pusa Dau Mosami, that is a club shape. This question, this is resistant varieties of some cucurbits like a cucumber, poinsettiate is there, and then watermelon, Arka Manik is there. In the, if you read in the water, tomato, the like Arka Rakshak, it is there. So you have to remember all the multiple disease risks. So I am given here the cucurbits. The ithrel, it is used for the production of female flowers, and then AGNO3, it is for the male flowers. Okay, then white spines are present in the slicing cucumber. If you, in case of pickling cucumbers, if you will found the black spines. Definitely they ask this question. Okay, and TSS of the muskmelon, it should it is the range of 12 to 17, it is the ideal PA, ideal TSS for the watermelon. Somewhat it is less, like 8 to 12. Then coming to the sex expression, definitely they will ask one question here, the expected, put a 10 star here, that is the male flowers, it is produced under the long day conditions, and then high temperature and high nitrogenous fertilizers. See, high nitrogen fertilizer, this question asked in the many examinations, so you focus on this one. Female flowers, followed with the short day, low temperature and low nitrogen fertilizers. Okay, and the cucurbits secondary branches, this is my thesis photo I am taken here. This is the secondary branches wherever it will come. It will predominate with the female flowers only. We will not found any male flowers in the secondary branches in cucumber. Then coming to the role of different hormones in the flowers, here also the one question they asked related to the plant growth regulators, PGRs. So ethylene precursor, you know, that is the methionine, which is the element is responsible for the ethylene synthesis, that is a copper. If you come across with the auxin, that is a zinc. So you have to read link with the other questions also. So if you ethylene it is there, if your precursor that is methionine, it will going to produce as the ethylene. So what are all the supporting elements? Like copper, it will supports the ethylene synthesis. But if you spray at initial stage with the GA3 or AVG, you know, that is the amino ethoxyvinyl glycine. If you spray this tube, it will blocks the ethylene synthesis. So that's why it will call ethylene biosynthesis blockers. Okay, then after synthesis of ethylene, so it will going to produce as the female flowers. It is a normal process. It will going to be as the female flowers. If you spray after reproductive stage of the cucurbits with the AgNO3, that is the silver nitrate and silver thiosulfate, it will action inhibitor of the ethylene. So that's why it will blocks the female flowers. It will going to produce as the male flowers. Then coming to the copper, it is most responsible element for the ethylene biosynthesis, we all know. So if you spray the AgNO3, how it is blocks the copper element? So because you can see in the this periodic table, that is a copper, it is a 29, it is the elemental number. Okay, somewhat it is a less, but if you see silver, that is a 47, it is there. If you spray the AgNO3, definitely the bigger person or the which having the higher molecular weight, it will going to suppress as the copper. So that's why the ethylene action will inhibited. This is the background for the action of silver thiosulfate and silver nitrate in the cucurbitaceous crops. Okay, then coming to the inbreeding depression in the cucurbit, it is nil, not medium, not low. Only you remember that is a nil only. What is the inbreeding depression then? Inbreeding depression you will only found in the cross pollinated crop, that is called CP crops. You will not found in the any self pollinated crops. What is the inbreeding depression? It is a one cross pollinated crop. If you remember, imagine, take the male flowers pollen and then pollinate the female flowers with the same flower pollen. If you pollinate this one, it will goes on decreases the their growth and development because it is a cross pollinated crops. We are doing self-pollinated in the cross-pollinated crops, so that's why it will give hindrance for the growth and development. So that's why it will goes on decreases the growth and development in the subsequent generations of the crop. So why? But if you see, cucurbits are cross-pollinated crops, okay? But it is adjusted to the self-pollination nature. Why? There is a one small story. It is for the SRF and ARS question. So I will give a hint. So here, why it is the inbreeding depression? It is very less because it is having the hermaphrodite flowers and inherent selfing nature it is there, and then homozygous allelic balance it is there, and lack of lethal genes which are responsible for the inbreeding depression. So that's why it is the nil nature it is there. Okay, within one minute I can give a story. Like if you remember in our past ancestors, okay, they are only having a fashion of planting one cucurbit plant in the near to our home, like a pumpkin they can plant or bottle gourd they can plant. Okay, there is no another plant source for the pollen source. Okay, that time what it will happen, the male flowers give a pollen source for the female flowers. Okay, so it will adjusted to the same pollen pollination in that same cucurbit. So goes on decreases the inbreeding depression nature in that cucurbits. Okay, that's the one reason. Then gynaecious nature, here you can remember that silver nitrate is a 250 to 300 ppm for the male flowers, and GA3 is also male flowers, and Cl is thiosulfate, the 400 ppm. So here it is no any logic or any science here. So you just remember, that's it. nothing any secondary. Okay, so here I given some of the genetic information about the all the cucurbits crops. Okay, so you try to remember whatever I am given here. Definitely the examiner asks these questions only. Okay, what are all those? The female flowers bears the, like F gene they can give, ACR gene they can give, or GY gene also they can give. Okay, GY, that is a gynaecious trait. And parthenocarpy in cucumber, that is maintained by is incomplete dominance gene in the cucumber, that is a parthenocarpic gene. Definitely this question is the favorite question for the SRF as well as the JRF question. Then coming to the fusarium wilt, FOX. So all the question, all the related to genes I am given in next slides also it is there. So here you try to remember these questions. So history about current system of cucurbits grafting, here also they can frame some questions like Japan and Korea, they are the leaders in the cucurbits grafting. What are all the crops like watermelon? It is the leading crop, as well as the pumpkin, and then another one, it is the muskmelon. They are the most leaders of this cucurbits grafting production. Okay, then here see the bottle gourd's root stock, it is used for the watermelon. Definitely this question they can frame in eggplant. Here it is the extra information, and then you try to take this snapshot and then try to remember which is the watermelon. Here they can definitely ask this one, Cucurbita moschata and Cucurbita maxima. This is the one rootstock, it is most widely used. I think it is start with the one, yes, that is a if anyone remember, it is start with the yes, Shorya
Silvia.
Please tell me loudly.
Sinodra.
Yeah, that one it is the use for the this is the graft hybrid of that hybrid resultant, that is that rootstock. They will ask definitely that question. So so try to remember this rootstock. And then you try to remember, these are all I am taken the recent publication, means journals, 2020. So they give the Thar Samriddhi, that is a bottle gourd, and Thar Karni ridge gourd, Thar Tapas, that is a sponge gourd, long melon, Thar Sheetal, it is there, and then Matira, that is Thar Manak. They can give the Thar Manak, Thar Karni, which is the variety. You have to answer that correctly. Then coming to the cucurbitacin, here the related to cucurbitacin, they are from the series like A to S series, it is there, and it is the chemical, it is called tetracycline triterpenes. Okay, this is the bitter principles in the cucurbits, and in B form it is the highest biological principle, very very important this one. Definitely they ask for the SRF, but the JRF it may ask or may not be asked also. Okay, and then it is more prevalent in the blossom end of the cucurbits, like you can see here, that is there. And then BI gene, that is the dominant gene, controls the bitterness in the cucurbits. They can ask the genetic inheritance of this cucurbitacin, that is the newly published. I have this photo, I have the PDF. So this is not published still now, this book. This is around 8000 rupees. They updated many things about these crops. Okay, I am taken all the source from that book only. And then coming to the cucurbitacin, it is there, and the mimodicin is present in the bitter gourd. Okay, and coming to the seed red, definitely they will not focus on the cucurbits, but you try to read. I am taken all the Tamburaj source for that seed rate here. Okay, and then pumpkin, it is highest seed rate variety in the cucurbits. And here definitely they will ask the question from this table, pointed gourd, what is stem cuttings they will use, ivy gourd, and then this is 3500, and then sweet gourd, and then spine gourd, and teasel gourd. This is the seed rate. And another one, chow chow, you can ask also, that is around 3500 to 4000 fruits they per hectare they can use for the planting. You can remember like why it is used as a stem cutting, because these are all dioecious cucurbits, and these crops bears the seeds with the recalcitrant nature. That is the main disadvantage. That's why we go with the propagation of stem cuttings or vegetative propagation in these cocoa beds. And then here some anti-nutritional factors like in the cocoa potassium, that is one major one, and choline esterase, that is in the pumpkin, and serotonin in the watermelon, and then aroma compound in the cucumber, that is the nanadiol. Okay, and it is a recent variety. It is an open pollinated, not J, that is the open pollinated variety, Arca Siri, it is there, and then watermelon, that is Arca Sham. These two are newly released from the IHR Bengaluru. You try to remember, and pumpkin also Thar Kavi, it is there, and bottle got Thar Samriti. Definitely, I am focused all the each and every angle of the cucurbits. You will not, the examiner will not skip from these questions. Okay, and what is the protected cultivation nature? See, the protected cultivation nature, the cucurbits are parthenocarpic plus gynoecious stripe. If only gynoecious stripe, that is not suitable for the protected cultivation. Why? Because they needs a additional adding of pollinators. So if you add a parthenocarpic trait with a gynoecious stripe, it is the most suitable nature for the protected cultivation. Then what are the cucurbits? Like cucumber, that is a Pusa parthenocarpic cucumber 6, and then Kerala parthenocarpic cucumber hybrid 1. This is the recently 2020 released variety by T. Pradeep Kumar. He is the head of the division in Kerala Agricultural University. He developed this variety, very very important. And parthenocarpic cucumber 6, this is developed by A.D. Munshi. He is the an eminent scientist in the IRA New Delhi. Many varieties in the cucurbits are traditionally bred by A.D. Munshi sir in the IRA New Delhi. And then muskmelon, that is Sarda melon, it is there, and bittergourd Pusa Rasdar. Okay, one story it is there. If you give a Pusa Rasdar for the farmers growing in the protected cultivation, they will not get the exact yield. Why? Because here only gynoecious trait it is there. There is no parthenocarpic trait. If you plant the Pusa Rasdar in the protected cultivation, we need to do the hand pollination. If you not do, our yield will not expected level. Then gynoecious lines in the cucumber, like gynoecious 1, 2, 3, these are all temperate origin, like IRA regional station Katrine, they are developed this one. And then gynoecious line 4, it is developed from the MPKV Rahuri, they developed this one with a parthenocarpic gynoecious trait. Using this gynoecious stripe, the MPKV Rahuri developed the two varieties, like a Pule Champa and Pule Prachi. They are developed this one. You will not found that hybrid cross anywhere, but I have that cross. I will give in the text box. Okay, try to remember, but it's a very big cross. Then coming to the new varieties in the cucurbits, like you can take a snapshot and then read well. Kashi Mayuri, it is there, and then Arka Neelachal Kaushi, it is also there, and then I will show you all the cucurbits which are released from the Arka Neelachal series in the next. Then here there is some recent magazines in 2020, they are mentioned. Definitely the journals question one will come in the SRF as well as the JRF. I am already put these questions in the previous slide. See, Arkashi Rakshita. So you try to remember. And food, this is Cookness Mellow variety, Memodica, it is there. And then this green mottled mosaic virus, that is the this species. And then Bunkinary, it is the dioecious cucurbit. Recently they are identified. Try to remember these questions, take a snapshot. And then see here the, okay, here it is not some very important. And coming to the some important questions here, you take a snapshot and then read well. Okay, I will tell one. See, Cucurbita lundeliana, this is resistant to powdery mildew, and then these are all also. And then another one, it is the Lufa acutangula, that is the ridge guard, that is having the anti-HIV property character. And the Cucumis hystrix, this is the natural cucumber hybrid, that is the Cucumis hystrix, that is cross between the Cucumis hystrix and cucumber. Okay, that is Cucumis sativus. So you try to remember this cross. And then see, richest source in the amino acids, that is in the cucurbits, methionine. And then highly toxic, this question it is asked in the new edition of TK Bose, definitely has, that is cucurbitacin used as the rodenticides, that is the 1.6 milligrams per kg. They can ask also, this is in the bitter gourd. And they may ask about the this cucurbitacin formula also. You try to read well about this one. And then the foetida, it is called this buffalo gourd, it is also propagated by rooting nodes. And see, Echinata, I already told you also, Luffa species, that is dioecious nature. And then apart from, I will go with the crop, there you will also find very important points also. I give an epithet as well as the odd seed code. And then see, sex ratio in the cucurbit, that is 25:1 or 15:1. And then cucurbits bears the flowers after planting 40 to 45 days after sowing only. Okay, and muskmelon, genetic andromonaceous character, it is a allelic combination, this one. I will give in the next slide when I am covering the muskmelon also with all the sex characters of that cucurbit. And then if you see some of the gynaecious strike in the Luffa, that is the AG, and the Behra sir is presently director of IIVR. Is developed the gynaecious bitter gourd varieties in the IRA New Delhi, that is the controlled by the gene GYG and DHS something, that is I am not remembering presently. So two varieties is there, Pusa hybrid 4, that is a bitter gourd variety which is bred through gynaecious strike. Okay, and then 24 leaf stage is the most successive stage for the growth regulator spraying. And then see, Parthenocarpi cucumber, very important variety, Diala, it is given in the TKBOS, very very important, you try to remember. And the Parthenocarpi gene in the cucumber, that is a PC gene controlled by the incomplete dominant gene. And the Parthenocarpi cucumber 6, it is the protected cultivation suitable. And then see, the cucurbits all are chilling injury at below 7 degrees Celsius, not somewhat the books are given 10 degrees Celsius, 7 degrees, so you go with the option it is present 7 degrees, because they given in the TKBOS, so that's why. And then Cucumis mellow, the muskmelon, it is a climatic fruit. And then full sleep, I will go with the crops. There you will found the information. You see, bridging species in the cucumis, that is a cucurbita pepo, that is summer squash, we have to transfer some of the green mottle mosaic virus from the martizani, that is a virus resistant having gene, through bridging species cucurbita moschata, that is the pumpkin. So it will used as a pumpkin, used as a bridging species in the transfer of many diseases in the summer squash. Okay, and then Charantia, it is the incompatible with the Memordica dioica, and then Balsamina, that is the Memordica Charantia, it is the bitter gourd. Okay, so it is incompatible dioica and then Balsamina. And then you see the scarlet gourd stem, means it is usually the which are the vegetative propagated crops with the stem cuttings length, it should be 15 to 20 centimeter length, and then diameter should be this much. This question asked, so that's why I put this question. And then coming to the vegetative Parthenocarpi found in scarlet gourd, okay, and bitter gourd, it is a crossable with the snake gourd. And then it is a chlorofluorine suitable for the Parthenocarpi induction in the cucumber, so try to remember this question. And then isolation distance, foundation seeds in the cucurbits, all cucurbits, that is a 1000 meters for the foundation seed, and then certified seeds is the 500. So you see the tag colors, that is foundation seed white color, and then truthfully labeled, that is I'm all given here, breeder seed golden yellow. And then if you see, go with the nuclear seeds, no breed, that tag color for the this one. So you try to remember all tag colors of the seeds. Acidic soils are suitable for the watermelon cultivation. So as you can see, nipping system, it is more suitable for the ridge gourd. So Swarna Yamini, it is a bitter gourd. And then these are all varieties you try to remember. And the Pusa Rasdar, you can see it is like a capsicum fruit. So it is for the protected cultivation. Pusa Purvi, you can see Arka Siri, and then Kashi Madhu, and then Haramadu. Haramadu, you know that one, it is the half leaf stage. Harvesting stage, full slip stage for the harvesting indices, but it is an exceptional character. And then Coming to the, I am different ancestors are the wild species of the cucurbits. I have given here. These are all I am taken from the Tiku Bose book. Okay, still it is not published. So Citrullus colocynthis and Citrullus ischirosus. This is the dioecious nature. Okay, this is a watermelon and very ancestors. These are all, and then Cucurbita taxana is there, and then if you can find, these are all wild species. And then Balsamina, it is there, and then Angi is also there, you can see. And then see, anybody can answer which is the cucurbit, this one. You can guess, please try to, anyone answer. If you wrong also, no worry, because we are learning.
Bottle god.
Okay, you are tried. Okay, I'm always welcome. But it is the Satputya, that is the god. That's why I put, this is the Satputya variety flowers. Good, you are, at least you are answering. And then Dispersius, and then Myriocarpus, these are all the ornamental cucurbits in the cucurbits crops. I don't know how it is ornamental, because it are very spines are there. Lufa ichinata, this is the dioecious nature cucurbit. Okay, Hardwicki, you know, this is the progenitor for the cucumber. Some physiological disorders, definitely they will ask one question from here. I will put one table also here. See, this cucumber here, pillowness, it is the calcium deficiency and blotting. This question asked in the ARS exam. So excess of carbon dioxide in the fruits, they become leathery like fruits. That is the blotting. You try to remember. I am focusing some physiological disorders only. I am not food. Sorry. All the cucurbits here, try to remember which I am stressing. Melons, that is a milliness. I am given the descriptions here. Blossom end rot, it is a somewhat same in the this one, in the our tomato also. And the fruit cracking, it is for the boron deficiency. White heart, very important. That is the iron deficiency and excess of fertilizers. This is the most important question for the examiner. Hollow heart, this is the most prevalent in the round fruits, not oval fruits. Okay, try to remember. And fruit of somewhat I focus some physiological disorders. You read that one only. Coming to the diseases, I'm not covered all the but diseases for your SRF as well as JRF purpose, which is important, I have given here. That is gummy stem blight. So you know, that is a poinsettia. It is resistant for powdery mildew, downy mildew, and gummy stem blight also. So that is the fungus, this one. And then seed borne disease, this is not a soil borne. Cucumber mosaic virus, that is spread by aphids. And the cucurbit green mottle mosaic virus, this is transmitted by also seeds. Okay, and somewhat it is also by aphids also, they give some reports. And try to remember all the cucurbits viruses, all Gemini viruses, this question asked. So I am stressing, try to remember. And then Tospo virus is also there in the watermelon and groundnut, and in also some cucurbits like in the watermelon it is more prevalent, and then groundnut also. This is the thrips spreading agent. And pest, this is the most important pest coming in here. What we have to remember here, fruit fly trap, it is the most devastating pest in the some palatable cucurbits for the pest. Like pheromone traps we have used, that is for the males, not for the females. They can ask also which the pheromone traps will attract which types, only for males. So coming to the Diarra cultivation, definitely one question they can ask. It is the off-season cultivation for the cucurbits cultivation only, not for the other cucurbits. Then coming to what is the special features of this Diarra cultivation. This is the riverbed cultivation. Mughal periods, it is started, and it is like a vegetable forcing. And then taproot vegetable crops are more prevalent in this system. And they asked in some questions, November to February or first week of March or end of March only, we will practice this off-season vegetable cultivation. Okay, the cropping cycle, definitely they will ask this from year to year only. Not because it is off season. Usually we will cultivate the all the cucurbits in the summer season. So here it is the cultivating the winter season. So that's why. it is a special compared to all the crops. 65% of the cucurbits, they are covers under the this system, and saccharum grass it is used. You can see here, this is for the protection of what, that is snowfall. You have to reduce the damage from the snowfall damage. I think you are somewhere away, where students are attending from the north, that is Gangetic Plains. Okay, in UP it is a majorly followed, and then TSS it is most and widely followed in the muskmelon, followed by watermelon, okay, and pointed gourd also. All the cucurbits they will follow, but majorly this watermelon and muskmelon, the crops. Then coming, okay, I think you're all exhausted. At least you this I am completed all the introduction about the cucurbits.
You concentrate on chromosome numbers, because there are more number of chromosome numbers, so please concentrate. Next one is sex forms. Okay, there are 8 types of sex forms, and you remember which sex form is present in which crop. Normally if you take gynoecious, it is present in cucumber. Okay, gynoecious parthenocarpi is suitable for greenhouse cultivation in cucumber. Okay, in cucumber, gynoecious parthenocarpi. Now this question was the most frequent question, and remember which are the dioecious cucurbits. Okay, with the code you remember which are the dioecious cucurbits. Next, anthesis time, which are the morning anthesis cucurbits, which are evening anthesis cucurbits. Please remember, definitely they will ask the question from anthesis part. After that, the conditions which help in the production of male and female flowers. Okay, like we are boys, okay, always we will come under stress. Okay, we can withhold stress, but not girls. Like male flowers always come under stress condition. Okay, male flower, like long day, high temperature, if there is any high nitrogen, these stress condition induce male flowers. Please remember. Okay, female flowers they won't come in stress condition, just a short day, low temperature and low nitrogen content, they will help in induction of female flower. And somebody was asked 15:1, 15 is what and 1 is which. 15 is always in cucurbits, 15 is always male flower, 1 is female flower. Okay, 15:1 is sex ratio in cucurbits. Don't confuse. 15 is male flower, whereas 1 is female flower. Cucurbits are having one tendency, they are having high tendency of production of male flowers. So always 15 is male flower, 1 is female flower, 15:1. Okay, normally in vegetable crops, in hybrid seed production, we will refer 4:1 or 8:1. 4 is female flower, 1 is male flower in hybrid seed production. But in cucurbits, don't confuse. In sex form, if they ask 15:1, that is 15 is male, 1 is female. Don't confuse. Okay. And you remember some of the growth regulators. Already I have said in a tomato also, PCP at high temperature and 244 parthenocarpi. Likewise, which are the chemicals help in the production of male and female flowers in cucurbits? Very important. Boys are like always silver and gold. Means silver thiosulfate and GA. G means gold. Always they induce male flowers. Okay. Likewise, I remembered. Just these are quotes. And very important, even you remember the concentration also, like silver thiosulfate, silver nitrate and GA3, they will definitely help in the exam. Okay, and the remaining part again the Pradeep will take over.
Okay, you can take, sir.
Okay.